everyone, and welcome back, my dear students. I hope you people are safe and healthy. In this video, we will start with arithmetic progression. First, let us learn what is arithmetic progression. A progression can also be written as a sequence. Here I have given the arithmetic progression is in the short form AP. A progression can also be called as a sequence. Let us have a quick definition. First, let us learn what do you mean by a sequence. I hope you people would have learned it already in your lower sections. Let us have a quick recall, children. A sequence is nothing but a sequence of real numbers. It's an arrangement or list of real numbers in specific order. Okay. What do you mean by real numbers? You people would have known already what is real numbers, right? A sequence is nothing but a arrangement of or list of real numbers which will be arranged in a specific order. Here I have given you some example. Here I have taken 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and so on. Okay, so here it is in the form of even number, right? So here the real numbers are arranged in some sequence, in some specific order. That we call it as a sequence. Okay, if you go for a sequence, sequence is of two types. One is finite sequence and the other one is infinite sequence. First, let us learn what do you mean by finite sequence. If a sequence have only one finite number of terms, then it is called a finite sequence. Here I have given you an example. 10, 20, 30 and 40. If you go for example, let us learn something. Here I have taken an example in which the numbers are countable, right? So 10, 20, 30 and 40, these are all countable set of sequence. That we call it as a finite sequence. If you go for the second example, 3, 6, 9, and 12. Okay? 3, 6, 9, and 12, and so on. It will keep on going, right? So it has infinite number of terms, which is uncountable. This will become under infinite sequence. I hope you people understand. Then go for arithmetic sequence or progression. If you go for a sequence, here we will learn about the two types of sequence. One is arithmetic sequence and the another one is geometric sequence. In this session, we are going to learn about arithmetic sequence alone. In the next video, we will be learning about the geometric sequence. Now, let us learn what do you mean by an arithmetic sequence. Arithmetic sequence is nothing but, here I have given you some definition. A sequence A1, A2, A3 and so on. An is called an arithmetic sequence if, here I have given one general form, okay, but here it is nothing but an-1 is equals to an+g, where n belongs to natural number. If you're going for the example problem, you people would have understand about this general form. Well, here we have to know what d and a are, okay. D is nothing but some constant and A is the first term of the sequence. Here I have given an example. 2, 5, 8, 11, 14 and so on is an AP. Okay, in this example, I am going to tell you what the first term and the common difference is. Common difference is nothing but if the particular sequence is given, the very first term of the sequence, this 2, right, will be considered as A1, the first term of the sequence. So A1 is equals to 2. And common difference is nothing but we have to, here I am going to subtract the term, each and every term, when subtracted by its preceding term. Okay. So here 2, 4, 8, 11 and 14 and so on is the given sequence which I have taken. Here I am going to find the common difference of this particular sequence. Okay, so if you are going to find the common difference 1, the first common difference, I am going to just subtract each and every term with its preceding term. Okay, so here I have the first term, so it has to be kept as such. Let me begin with the second term. If the second term is 5, right? Here I am going to subtract this term with this preceding term, that is 2. So if you subtract the 5 from minus 2, what you will be getting up? Answer will be 3, right? So your common difference will be 3. And then if you are going for the second difference, D2, which is nothing but here I am going to subtract the next two terms, that is 8 should be subtracted with its preceding term. Your answer will be 8 minus 5 is also 3. And then if you are going for the third common difference, D3, here I'm going to subtract the third term, 11 and 8. So 11 should be subtracted with its preceding term, 8. Your answer will be 3, right? So here, in the given arithmetic progression, I came to know all the common difference, whatever the from the given sequence, whatever the elements should be subtracted with the preceding term, my common difference must be same. Okay, this is the condition for a certain sequence to be an arithmetic sequence. I hope you people understand till this. Now let us going to learn one important thing now, which is very important in AP, that is the general form of an AP. Okay, how the arithmetic progression will be. Okay, here I have given you one general form. This is the general form of a AP. Kindly do remember this. The general form of an arithmetic progression is nothing but A plus D, the second term, A plus 3, 2D, the third term, A plus 3D, the fourth term, and so on. It will keep on going. Okay, it is endless. Okay, here I have taken the general arithmetic progression for the infinite sequence. Okay, I will give you one important example here. Here I have taken one sequence, okay, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. Here I am going to substitute these values in the general form of an AP. What will happen? Let us learn. Already in the first slide I have told you, what is A? That is the first term of an AP which is given, right? So here, the first term of an AP is 1. So let me take A here. Then how will you find the common difference? Common difference is nothing but each and every term of a sequence should be subtracted with this preceding term, right? If you are subtracting the second term, the first term, what will be left out? 2. Okay, if you are going for the second term, 5 minus 3 also 2. So here same common difference, all the common differences are equal, so it will be considered as the AP, right? So here I am going to tell why we are using this general form, where we are using this general form of an AP. Here in the given sequence, we found what A and D, that is the first term and common difference of the sequences, right? So here I am going to substitute these two values, A value and D value, in the general form which I have given here, in the general form of an AP. This is the general form of an AP. Here I am going to substitute the values of A and D. Now what will happen? So in place of A, I am going to substitute 1. In place of D, I am going to substitute 2. Now what will happen on substituting? My answer will be 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and so on, right? So this is the AP. This is the general sequence which I have taken here. Okay, so on substituting all the values in the general form of an AP, we will be getting a sequence which we have taken. So in this way, we have to use the general form of an AP. And you people clear about this now. Okay, children, till now we have seen just the introductory part of the given sequence, arithmetic sequence. Now let us begin with the problems here. Here I have given the first problem as, check whether the following sequence is an arithmetic progression or not. Okay, here the given sequence is 2, 6, 10, 14. Okay, the only thing, the only condition, if you want to show only the given sequences, check whether the given sequence is progression or not, the only thing all you want to do is, you just want to check whether each and every one of the term when subtracted by its preceding term should have the same common difference. Here I gave you the note, no? You have to remember this. Here let's go for the solution. From the sequence I have taken the first term 2. Okay. The only condition is you just want to show all the common difference of the sequence should be same. Okay. This is the condition for a sequence to be arithmetic sequence. Here I want to check the common difference 1. How to find the common difference 1? I want to subtract the second term with the
first term. Here, the first term of the sequence is 2. And then the second term of the sequence is 6. I'm going to subtract each and every term with its preceding term. That is 6 minus 2. Your answer will be 4. That is common difference 1 is 4. Then go for the second common difference. 10 minus 6 is nothing but that is also 4. Then if you're going for third common difference, that is also 4. Okay. So the condition is, since D1, D2, D3, that is the three common differences, are same, okay, it is enough to show that all the common differences of the given sequence is same, then only you can say the given sequence is an arithmetic sequence. If you are going for the second problem, that is 5, 9, 12, 18 and so on, what is the first term of the sequence? 5. Then how to find the common difference? D1 is equals to 9 minus 5 is nothing but 4. And D2, the second common difference is 12 should be subtracted. 9 should be subtracted from 12. Answer will be 3. Right? Here, D1 is 4 and D2 is 3, which is not equal. Am I right? So here comes the condition. D1 is not equal to D2. Already I told you how to check whether the given condition, how to say the condition, given sequence is progression, arithmetic progression or not. Simple, you have to say the common difference, all the common differences are same for the sequence, okay? But here if you are going taking these two common differences, they are not equal, you can simply say the given sequence is not an arithmetic sequence. Okay, let me tell you again. How to check whether the given sequence is arithmetic sequence or not? It is simple. It is enough to show that the common difference of the sequence is equal. Okay, now go for the general term of an AP. What is general term of an AP? An AP has so many number of terms, right? We can find out any number of terms, any term setting on any position, that is called the nth term of an AP, which is denoted by Tn. Okay, is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, if in the question they have given, find the nth term of the sequence, if any particular sequence is given, all you need to do is, you just want to replace n as the given nth term. Okay, already we know about the first term of the sequence and the common difference of the sequence. Hence, meanwhile, we can find out the nth term of that particular sequence. So this is also very important. You have to remember the very first two points, the very important two points you have to remember in the arithmetic progression, that is the general form of the sequence and the general term of the sequence. General form of the sequence and the general term of the sequence. Okay, children, let's go for the second problem. The question is, write the first four terms of the arithmetic progression when the first term A and the common difference D are given. Okay, in the first problem, first subdivision, they have given the first term as 10 and the common difference as 10. What you have to do? In first problem, we have seen how to check whether the given condition, given sequence is arithmetic sequence or not. Okay, but here they have given the arithmetic sequence. From this given data, we have to find the first four terms of an arithmetic sequence. How to find the first term of the arithmetic sequence? Which is nothing but, already I told you, A is given and D is also given. So it is enough to substitute in the general form of an arithmetic sequence. Okay, so what is the general form of an arithmetic sequence? A plus D, A plus 2D and A plus 3D. Okay, which keep on going. But here, they asked us to find only the first four term of an arithmetic sequence. Okay, so that only I have taken A plus D, A plus 2D and A plus 3D. It is enough to substitute all the given values in the general form. You will be getting the required sequence. So now what will happen? In place of A, I am going to substitute 10. In place of D also, I am going to substitute 10. My answer will be 10, 20, 30 and 40. This is the first four terms of an AP. Hope you people remember. This is very important and easy problem also. Keep practicing, children. Now the third problem is, for the following AP, Find the first term A and the common difference D. This is very simple problem. Here the given sequences 3, 1, minus 1 and minus 3. From the given sequence, we have to find the first term and the common difference. Already we know about this. So what is the first term of the sequence? 3, right? And then how to find the common difference of the sequence? Which is something that here I'm going to subtract the second term and the first term, that is t2 minus t1. What is the second term of the sequence? 1. And the first term of the sequence is 3. If you subtract, answer will be minus 2. So that will be your common difference. Now go for the fourth problem. Find the 24th term of the sequence. Here the sequence is given as 12, 10, 8, 6 and so on. So the sequence keeps on going. Here they have given only the four terms, right? The first term is 12, the second term is 10, third term is 8 and fourth term is 6. It will keeps on going. If it keeps on going, we have to find the 24th term of the sequence. And what will be the 24th term? Here let us see. The solution is given. From the given sequence, we can write the 12th, first term of the sequence, right? So first term is 12. And then what is n? N is 24. That is what we have to find. The 24th term we have to find. So we have to take n as 24. So first thing what you have to do here is we want to check whether the given sequence is arithmetic sequence or not. So how to check? The same arithmetic sequence should have the same common difference. Am I right? So it is enough to check that. So D1 is equals to the second term minus the first term, that is 10 minus 12 is answer, minus 2. And D2 is 8 minus 10, answer will be same, minus 2. So we can say since D1 is equals to D2, that is we have the sequence have same common difference, then it is called as AP. So what you have to find here, we have to find T24, that is the 24th term of a sequence, that is the 24th term of the sequence. It is enough to substitute all the values which is given in the general term of an AP. What is the general term of an AP? Tn is equals to A plus N minus 1 into T. I told you people to remember this formula. So in place of N, I'm going to substitute 24. In place of A, I'm going to substitute 12. In place of D, I'm going to substitute minus 2. On simplification, my 24th term is minus 34. Hope you people remember. People understand what I'm trying to say. Then the fifth problem is how many terms are there in the sequence. This is also the same problem, but the question is just a little bit difficult. So here the sequence is given. So from this we have to take the first term A, right? The first term of a sequence is 4, and then we have to check whether the given sequence is AP or not, right? So the given sequence D1 is equals to 7 minus 3. So the first common difference is 3 and the second common difference is also 3. So can I say the given sequence is arithmetic sequence? Okay, so the given sequence is arithmetic sequence with the first term as A and the common difference as 3. Now we want to find, they have given the nth term of the sequence. In which term the number 148 is placed? We have to find the n here, okay? So what you have to do in last problem, n is given, we found what the nth value, that particular nth term, right? But here we the nth term value is given, we want to find in which position this value is placed, okay? So here tn is equals to 148. I have taken this for term as equation 1, and then we already know the general term, right? An is equals to Tn is equals to A plus N minus 1 into 2. So here I am taking this equation as equation 2. Here also Tn. Here also Tn. So can I equate these two? What will happen? A plus N minus 1 into D. If obviously left hand side is equal for two equations, obviously right hand side will also be equal. So can I equate all these right hand side? What will happen? A plus N minus 1 into D is equals to 148. I know what A is, right? So value of A is 4 and then value of D is 3. Here I'm going to just find the value of N. Okay, if you bring this 4 to the next side, it will become minus 4. Answer will be 144. If you bring this 3 to the next set, it will become divided by 3 because here it is in multiplication. So on dividing, your answer will be 48, right? So if you are bringing minus 1 to the next set, it will become plus 1. So n is equals to 48 will be your answer. So how many terms are there in the sequence? There are 49 terms on the given. Let's go for the sixth problem. What is given? Determine the arithmetic progression whose third term is 5 and the seventh term is 9. Okay. So here I'm going to take the given data as T3. That is, the third term should be denoted as T3, as 5. Okay. So T3 can be written as A plus 2D. How T3 can be written as A plus 2D? Here I'm going to compare this term with the general form of an AP. Okay. So T1 is the first term of an AP, right? So what is the T1, a general form of an AP? A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. Already I told you where A will be your first term, that is T1. A plus D will be your second term, T2. A plus 2D will be your third term, T3. So that A plus 2D is equals to 5. This will be considered as your equation 1. What is given again? T7, that is the seventh term, will be 9. So how the seventh term of a sequence can be written? So A plus 60. Obviously, A plus 60 is equals to 9. So this will be considered as second equation. Here I'm going to solve the first and second equation. That's it. Okay, in order to find A and D. Now what can I do for that? Here I'm going to subtract these two equations. Okay, so if you subtract equation 1 from equation 2, what will happen? What is your equation 2? A plus 60. This will be your left hand side, and equation 1 is A plus 2D. Subtracting, and then subtract the right hand side, 9 minus 5. Now I'm going to subtract these two equations. Now what will happen? I have minus, right? Here I'm going to multiply each and every term of this, which present inside the bracket, with minus. Now what will happen? Plus A will become minus A, and plus 2D will become minus 2D. After this, plus A and minus A will get cancelled, right? Now what will be left out? 6D and 2D will be left out. So 6D minus 2D will be your 4D. So 4D is equals to 4. If I bring this 4 to the next set, it will become 4 by 4. Then what will be your D value? Answer is D is equals to 1. Here we found what the common difference is, right? Then I'm going to substitute the D value in equation 1. What is equation 1? A plus 2D is equals to 5. Now in place of D, I'm going to substitute 1. What will happen? 2 into 1 is 2. So answer is 3. Here I have what A and D is, right? So I'm going to substitute these A and D, that is the first term and the common difference of the AP, in the general form of an AP. Because what is the question here? I want to find the general form of an arithmetic progression. Okay. So what is the general form of an arithmetic progression? A plus D, A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and so on. So in place of A, I'm going to substitute 3. In place of D, I'm going to substitute 1. Now what will happen? Your answer will be 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is your required arithmetic progression. Then go for seventh problem. These are all very important problem and easy problem also. Please keep learning, children. The seventh problem is, what is given? The sum of fourth and eighth term. What is the sum? Sum means we have to add these two terms, right? So the sum of the fourth and eighth term of an AP is 24, given. And the sixth and tenth term is 24. Then find the three terms of an AP. Now what will happen? What first we have to write the first term of an AP. Sorry, the first three terms of an AP. What is the first three terms of an AP? A plus D, A plus 2D. Because that is the question. That is what we have to find out. The first three terms of an AP, right? So here I'm taking this term as equation A, capital A. So here already we know the A will be the common first term of an AP and D be the common difference. So in question, what is given? The sum of fourth and eighth term, right? So fourth term will be represented as T4, and eighth term will be represented as T8. What is sum? Here I'm going to add these two terms. My answer will be 24. 24 is also given in the question itself. So T4 can be written as A plus 3D. T8 can be written as A plus 7D is equals to 24. Okay, here I'm going to add these two terms. What will happen? A plus A will become 2A and 3D plus 7D will become 10D, which is equal to 24. Here I'm going to divide the whole equation with 2. What will happen? Answer will be A plus 5D plus 12, right? So this will be considered as first equation. Also, what is given? The sixth term, the sum of the sixth term and the 10th term of a sequence is 34. Okay, sixth term can be written as T6 and 10th term can be written as T10, which is equal to 34. So sixth term will be A plus 5B and 10th term will be A plus 9B equal to 34. Now I'm going to add A and A will become 2A and 5A, 5D and 9D will become 14D, right? Here also I'm going to divide the equation by 2. Your answer will be A plus 7D is equals to 17. So this will be your equation 2. As we have done it already, here also I'm going to subtract those two equations. So if you subtracting those equation 2 and equation 1, you will be getting the value of D, right? Here I got the value as D as 5 by 2. Here I'm going to substitute the value of D in equation 1. Obviously, we'll be getting the value of A. That is, A is equals to minus 1 by 2. Hope you people can solve it by yourself. These are all very easy simplification only. After finding A and D value, it is enough to substitute all these value which we found now in the general form, that is the in equation A, okay? That is, what is equation A? A plus D, A plus 2D. On substituting these values, your required arithmetic progression will be minus 1 by 2, 2 and 9 by 2. Now here we came to the end of the session, children. These are all the points you have to remember in this session today. The first thing what you have to remember is the general form of an AP. This is very, very important, children. Please you remember the general form of an AP is A, A plus D, A plus 2D and A plus 3D. And then general term. Please you have to learn the difference. What is general form and what is general term? General form is A, A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D and so on. And general term is whenever you are finding the word a term, obviously you have to come across Tn form, okay? Tn is equals to A plus n minus 1 into D. How to say whether the given, sequence is arithmetic progression or not? We have to say only if the common differences between two consecutive terms is same for each and every term. Okay, already we have known what is finite and infinite sequence. These are all the basic things you have to learn from this today's session. Here I gave you some assignment problem for you people to work out. So see you children in the next video. I hope this will be your, hope you people can understand this session. This arithmetic progression is very important chapter, children. It's vastly used in mathematics in all the sessions. That is in calculus, in basic algebra, everywhere, wherever you are going. If you are going for higher studies also, this is very important. You have to learn it thoroughly. So we have to need a good knowledge in AP. So keep practicing. Keep learning. Stay safe, children. See you people in the next video. Thank you.